Hey guys, Broke Hair Pairs, and welcome back to my favorite 17 Westerloak Rambles. I'm gonna have to train myself not to accidentally say I'm Carper. If you missed the last video, the last secondary Rambles video of the year you would have seen it. Excuse me, it would have been my local Rambles video. Oh. But if you didn't see Sunday's video, oh, this is my brand new secondary promo, but after finishing the one with Ankar Burn, I'm playing with Belgian side SV Whisper. KBC Whisper. Oh, and I'm relishing it because it's like a challenge. It's another team that you don't expect much from. I went just over this in the last episode, but I'm gonna turn them into the Belgian Leicester. Unfortunately, that's the best comparison that I can give, because that's the best example of an underdog title winner, unless Red Bull Leipzig can finally end Bayern's reign of dominance, as they seemingly threatening to, but Bayern are ahead of them, so no guarantee that they're going to do a Leicester. For capitalized on the big teams failing. Bayern Munich don't seem like they're gonna fail.
Great stop. Here's a chance for Westerlo from a corner.
No. Maybe a situation where I capitalize on teams dropping hints or anything like that. I don't. But yeah, we'll see. I haven't really established anything yet because this is only game 3. I'm already facing a second team that you could consider a title rival in Ghent.
Good save, but straight into the path of the attack.
I mean, the big teams that you normally associate with the Pro League are Ghent, Standard Liège, Anderlecht, Club Brugge, I feel like I'm forgetting someone.
And that has opened the scoring, 1-0 here.
I might be forgetting someone, but yeah, it's like a select group that, you can look at that team and say, oh, that they're gonna be a part of that. Yeah, title race come the end of the season.
They've got the second, and they've hit them hard.
If I am forgetting someone, please forgive me. My knowledge of the Belgian league isn't great.
Human on the sideline.
So, yeah, please forgive me if I've skimmed over you and treated you like I don't care, because I don't care, I do.
A return ball.
And if I did leave you out, it wasn't on purpose, please. Believe me. When I say that.
Well, this attack.
What will we do? Yes. So.
And that clearly is a goal kick.
Well, so far, not so good. Right? Two things in the first episode. Good. And I'm well on my way to getting a third win here. I'm already at my goal limit so far. Is both of my wins in the first episode were by 2 goals. So will this be the first game where I surpass 2 goals? Just.
He's coming forward.
Maybe. Yes, it is. It's going to involve the score. Here's the second goal in consecutive games for his second out of the season. He makes it 3 now, wins that header beautifully. That is fantastic. Hey, aerial holds. Well, stop. That is what you want from the striker. When you whip a ball in, it's good to have the option if your team can support that option.
Until that point, when it broke down, now they've got to try and regain possession.
It's not a small dude, so I had a good feeling of him winning that header, and he rewarded my faith with the winning the header. Sure, he scored there. Oh, and he just scored from the rebound as well. Well, the keeper pulled off the save after the woodwork came to his aid the first go around. That's annoying, but I'll deal with it. For another corner. Pressure is beginning to mount. And it's cleared away like nothing.
I think Gal and the home team need a win. A couple of draws.
Never mind.
Slightly unsatisfactory. Yeah.
Wait. Oh! God, are you kidding me? Fucking. Shot. Freaking. Taking a shot at, like, the nerdy in the gym. Yes. 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 For all my American viewers.
The referee has chosen 4 added minutes.
P, as it's better known to us here in the European continents.
Good pass, getting it forward. And the cross comes in now. Well, there is the referee blowing for half time. It's 3-0 here.
It's like that guy. Hey? And we all know for a guy like that who when he played football. Oh. When
they've been very good, the team that are leading, of course.
The on the day here, the origin. I don't even know if you got if you Americans even play soccer to you guys, because you don't call it football. Well, your football is what we call rugby, and just to clarify, it is the exact same sport. Let's just be honest here.
Watch out. Very good. So,
slightly different rules, but yeah, it is pretty much the same sport. You got to be blind to not see that it is indeed the same sport. And anyone who tells you any different is a bit of an idiot.
Cut off! Oh, saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch.
No offense to any Americans who really take offense to that, but it is the same sport. I don't know which copy which, but and why Americans are so dead on calling their version of American football when, dude, it's rugby. It's rugby. That's what it is. Call it what it is, or if it's American, If American football came first, then we should be calling rugby American football, because it's the same thing. Basically, there's a little bit difference in the rules and the color of the ball. But it's the exact same thing. It is the exact same thing.
That's the sort of corner that frustrates the coaches, because they obviously have plans. The delivery wasn't...
I'm not here to argue this.
A menace to it.
I'm not a fan of any nonsense. Like, I'll watch the Super Bowl when it's on. I won't be watching the Super Bowl. I don't watch it live. For one, because it's Royal Rumble week. When the Super Bowl was on, which I think is tomorrow. Correct me if I'm wrong. It's normally on around the same time as the Royal Rumble. Well, for my fellow WWE fans, that's what we were glued to our screens about.
Just a chance to tell you about a confirmed transfer here. Mats Hummels has joined
on Sunday. When this will actually be first of his career mode went up on that same day as well. So, coincidence? I think not. No, it is. It's just a huge fucking coincidence. But yeah. Well, am I invested in his innings? I don't really follow American football, but, you know. I am.
To switch on the
I always do check who wins just to see, you know. Like, if I'm ever talking. Because I actually know some Americans who live in. Here in Ireland. Good friends of mine. And that's what we talk about. Well, am I talking? Yeah. Am I sure? Yeah, so yeah.
To front so quickly.
I try to be as informed as possible on the American sports.
It's turning out to be
same with baseball.
Well, the home team
in the NBA.
And the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think. Haven't they just? You could hear a pin. Oh, he's through. Shots on here. Oh, well saved. And the cross is in. Keeper comes and claims it, and no great risk.
Especially the NBA, really, because the guys I know are from Miami, so they're huge Heat fans. And that's the Miami Heat.
Now they count
for U.S. fans who think I'm talking about actual like backstage. That's not what I'm talking about. The Miami Heat. Wrestling fans will know him best because The Rock mentioned him once. It's a segment with Michael Cole. And I don't know where I'm going with this, talking randomly about other sports. Let's just stick to football. Well, and those of you watching me in Ireland, yes, I call it football because the Irish, the Gaelic football, the Irish version of the game is complete bullshit. It's a fucking rubbish sport. And hurling is just poor man's cricket, which is sad. It's pretty much the only difference is that you're not limited to one space. And no one throws the ball at you and you have to hit it. So, a lot of people like to compare cricket and baseball. I can certainly see the comparison. A guy throws the ball at a guy and he hits it with a bat-like thing. Although I think they have a different name for the thing they use in cricket. I don't know what it's called because I don't watch cricket because I think it's shit. No offense to you guys, to you English people, but I just can't get invested in cricket because it makes no fucking sense. Why does it take several days? I mean, like, if your sporting event takes several days and it's not a tournament of some description or a league, if it's a game, it shouldn't take longer. It shouldn't last multiple days. That should only be the case if it's a tournament of some description, or a league, or something like that. Cricket, that doesn't make any sense. It really doesn't. Even baseball doesn't do that. Baseball, well, their games finish. They don't continue the next day. It'll be like the team that is losing in baseball. They'll say, hey, and forgive me if I pick American fans, if I pick any team that you don't like, just inform me because I'm gonna pick two teams that I just know. That's the Red Sox and the Yankees. They're the two most ones I know. One, because I'm a Liverpool fan, and our owners aren't the same guys who own the Red Sox. That's why I mostly know them. And the Yankees are one of the biggest teams in baseball history, from what I can gather. Again, just picking those off the top of my head, to be honest. And, say they're playing, one of them is losing, say the Yankees are losing, they're about to lose. But the Yankees hold up their hands and say, let's continue this tomorrow. Red Sox will be like, what the fuck are you talking about? We finished this now. This match doesn't continue tomorrow. You can't just say, oh, let's continue this tomorrow. Well, or the winning team going up to the losers and say, we could beat you now. We got this thing on, so we got bounce. So we have to leave, so we gotta continue this tomorrow or in the next couple of days. And we're like, what? This doesn't make any goddamn sense. Yeah, but this is just the way it is. No, that really does not make any goddamn sense. Who wants a bigger role? Fuck. Trying to sign these players is fucking pain in the ass. But yeah, that's my opinion on those. On that. That'd be like football. But you might have time if they're losing or even if they're winning. Or if the losing team can go up to the winning team and say, we know we've played 45 minutes, we have about 45 minutes to play. Instead of doing that right now, we're gonna pounce and we're gonna do it in our time. Wait, what? You can't fucking do it, you just can't up and leave. If you do that, really, you forfeit. That's what you do, you forfeit. You can't just decide what you do when. Whenever you want to do it, you just can't do that. That's not how life works. So, the fact that cricket games span a few days is completely stupid. know, maybe if I were an avid watcher and an avid fan, I would understand the game better, but really, I can't see any good reason for it to be held over a few days. It really has no reason to. And they have one-day games. One-day internationals. I'm like, you have these types of games, yet your more popular games are the ones that last a few days. What? That makes no fucking sense. That's completely bullshit. Now maybe there's another topic. Now maybe there's another sport out there that I don't know off the top of my head that lasts a number of days. And before anyone comes to me with like the World Series, because that's a series of games, or the NBA Finals, which is a series of seven games.
Still fairly early on, Martin, but these two teams have started the season really well. Second versus.
Technically, those are all different games. In cricket, it's the same game continued on over multiple days. I'm like, why? That makes no sense. There's no good reason for it. It really, there he is.
Team's defense.
I'm just going to stop talking about it. I don't know why I've been on as long as I have. But I have.
These lot haven't forgotten, that's for sure.
Terrific entertainment on offer here, I'm sure, as the game gets underway. Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team. I think that back four is really important for them. They've got to be strong and solid, but they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
They have. They should have.
And he could get away here.
Gimbola. Ah, the player. Here for the opposition team got the block in right at the crucial time. Something good from this corner, Henry.
They're grateful for that, to have an intervention like that.
Bad. God damn it.
For a throw-in. Highland, into the attacking third.
And voila.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Highland! Boom! First goal of the season for Highland. I'm probably saying his name wrong.
I have to say, he reacted perfectly. Really sharp right from the...
I really wish you could, like, knock down that stupid, dumbass cameraman. But hey, he's getting in on the act. He's in the middle of all the celebration.
Here's the goal again.
Very nice, pointy finish from the central midfielder. Here.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
And, yeah. Pretty standard.
Looking good, this move. Probing away, trying to find room for a shot, maybe. That attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance. Gets his foot in there.
Pretty standard goal, really.
Nicely played through ball.
Alpo.
It's a corner. And he's up for the header. Comes in with a tackle. And he's given the free kick.
God damn it. I really hate when the referee gives away these stupid random free kicks for nothing.
Well, they're in a good position here. I think the two teams were going to play on here, but the referee has stopped it for this injury. Well, the injured player has gone off. We're going to get the game restarted with a drop ball. Well, he's beaten his man.
Go on, Henry. Ah, oh, yes.
Well, well, wide.
I have no words for that. That makes no sense. How did I not score that? God damn it. It's one of those head scratching. It's really, isn't it?
That challenge.
Alpo. Canvola.
Here's a chance.
Well, can he make up for it? Yes, he can. I don't know if I'm saying his name right, probably not. But the guy who missed the opportunity a few minutes who redeems himself.
Against a position where they wouldn't be expecting to win the game, they would expect it to be
quite.
But there seems to be an inner
line that in the back of the net perfectly.
Although we all think it's evenly matched.
On back or out. Back up full last.
Restarting at 2-0.
I don't know how to pronounce his name. I will work on it, trust me. Eventually. When I get some time.
Moving forward with some.
I just started this criminal. Give me some time.
The goalkeeper that time hung on to the ball well. That could open them up. Attacking now. And it's a shot now. They stopped him in the nick of time.
Post. You gotta be kidding me, man.
Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. And the board has gone up to indicate 3 added minutes.
Penalty. Yeah, I know. I don't understand how that was a penalty either.
And the referee is blown for half time. It's 2-0 here. Second half started here by Westerlo. Some potential in this move. Real chance. So close. The post. And the take wasn't very convincing, was it? Here's the picture regarding Paul Pogba and his deal done now, it's confirmed he has moved to Manchester United.
Well, you can understand when you see his track record why they've spent about £85 million on him.
For Ari faith in to say, which is why I'm going a bit quiet there. Sorry about that. It's not. I'm actually trying to think of things I can talk about.
Well, he has cleared the danger.
I mean, I could say that's a penalty. But I am clearly wasting my breath.
Steered it. Very classy.
Nice finish at the tight angle.
Came close to goalkeeper, actually did get a touch on it, but I think it was a pretty good
finish to do that much. I really wish I had more to offer, I guess.
It's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway. Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go. Good, strong tackle. It's very good skill. He's made the defender look a bit awkward there.
Normally, I don't have anything to really talk about. I just do like commentary. He would say the player's name. Things as they're doing their stuff on the ball, but I don't know most of the players. And like I said, this is brand new. This room with just stuff. It's today, and this is only the second video. I haven't gotten used to anything yet.
It's going to be his throw here. Never quite as simple as you think.
I haven't done that.
That's good support play from his teammates. Space to try and hit it now. Goes for it with a fist. It's a good ball. They could pass it deflected in by the goalkeeper.
That's a good finish. I'm legitimately surprised that was not offside.
Replay confirming for us here that the goalkeeper did get a touch, but not strong enough to keep the ball out of his net.
Well, he is his own harshest critic, this lad, and he'll blame himself for that, I think, having got a touch.
So they're looking for more at 4-0. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. This might be it. He has come to the rescue this time. The goalkeeper will get this one, no problem.
Yeah, I really wish I had something to talk about. See, it's moments like this that make me maybe I should, just give you guys gameplay and not commentary.
You would have thought ability-wise, it's...
But I don't know how that would come over.
One side seems far more up for it than the other.
Yeah, I think that does seem to be the case.
It's a quick break. Really in the clear now, in on goal. Shot up! What a lovely death finish that was. Goalkeeper was reaching for it.
Yeah, a real big thing about that.
Power on the
in time to come.
Strong enough touch.
If you're losing count, it's five.
I'm thinking about it more and more, you know.
Good position. They've worked this attack very well.
Because on one hand, the commentators can get annoying. I know that. Sometimes they try me up the wall. But it'd be nice to hear, because sometimes they have interesting stuff to say, and, especially if I'm playing a game like that.
Yeah, almost done.
Who what did he do? Who has the upper terms of dial? Maybe I won't go strictly the quiet videos. Maybe some videos will be just the game. And some videos will be.
Very big margin of victory.
Yeah, they were ruthless actually. Quite often, last 10 or 15, you ease off, but this team did.
We'll polish out what we have. To talk about if there is anything, I'll let you guys know. Maybe I'll try it out, but I'll let you guys know. And when I do, you'll be the first. But I won't make that decision right now. I'll wait, and maybe it'll be next episode. I don't know. We'll see. Until then. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash like button if it's very good. Until next time, you all have a very nice day. Peace.